Hello friends, welcome to the Pioneer of Success, an online education institute. Here in this video, we'll learn how to use internet during day timing in IIT Guwahati. So this video is mainly made for IIT Guwahati students because we all know that usage of internet from 8 a.m. in the morning to 5 p.m. in the evening and 2 a.m. in the midnight to 5 a.m. in the morning is prohibited because we all need to give a proxy in order to access to the internet. We all have an account, we log in through this account and we can use internet. But during this time period which I mentioned earlier, the internet is not, internet does not work because it is prohibited by that proxy server. So here I will tell you how to use internet during this time, and you will be able to do whatever you want to do in internet. So but before going into details of this video, I'd like to mention something about our online academy. It is an academy which is mainly made because of the for the purposes of engineering studies. So that basically we make videos on programming languages, we make videos on engineering mathematics, we make videos on several things which we in general require to study an engineering course. So here I request all of you to please subscribe to my channel, and also the people who are willing to work with us, they are requested to contact me at in this mail IDs, and I will be happy to work with you and I will be happy to reply to your email. So now going to the main topic, that is how to use internet in IIT Guwahati. So suppose for that you need to download a software that is called Gproxy. You have to have Gproxy software installed in your system. At the same time, you have to have a system that works in the academic building or computer center of IIT Guwahati. Suppose I tell you, I am a student, I am a research scholar of Indian Institute of Technology Guwahati, so I have a system in my laboratory. So there the internet works 24/7, that you all know. So in this system, what I did, I installed Gproxy. So this one is the Gproxy, it is already installed. I will give you the link with this video. In the below section you will find the link of the Gproxy. You can download it and you can install in your system. So once you install, I just pin it up in the here. Okay, so I'll show you from the beginning. So I am just opening this Gproxy. Now it is open. Now say this is the Mozilla browser. Now you all know where you need to give the proxy. So you go to options, you go to advanced setting, network, and then settings. So this is the proxy given to research scholar, that is 202.141.80.80. For BTech students it might be 20, for intake might be 19 or something like that. So this proxy is given to me and I am using this one in order to access internet. So this proxy will work when you are in academic building, that is you are in research laboratory, you are in the computer center. So for 24/7 it will give this proxy, it will work. But when you are in hostel, it will not work. So but you can do, you can make, if you understand the thing, this laboratory system works 24/7. So what I am doing, I am virtually using this proxy to any other server or any other computer in order to access internet during the prohibited time. So basically the proxy of this internet we will be using in some other computer. How to do that? So you go to Gproxy. yeah, this is Gproxy. So what I did, I gave my proxy 202.141.80.80 and the port is 3128. Now you have, all of you have a an account having your username and password. So what I did, this is my username, Shirshan USHIRCNDU, sorry, and then I gave the password. So you also give your respective password and then choose a port. You can choose anything. Suppose I choose 1234, anything you can choose. Okay, it should be 4 digit, anything you choose. Now check this box, that is allow other people in LAN to use my internet connection. What does it mean? It means I'm just sharing that internet connection, and any person staying at IIT Guwahati can use the proxy, and he or she has to be connected with LAN, by LAN. Okay, so 1234 I have given the proxy, and this is the download limit. You make it as much as possible. I generally make it few nines, I just put, and then click on start proxy. Now what I did, I made a new proxy that can be used anywhere in IIT Guwahati if you are connected by LAN. Now the proxy which I made would be the IP address of this computer, and the IP address you can find it here. Just right click on it, open internet sharing, just a minute, Ethernet, yeah, properties, yeah, this is the IP address of this system. So every system in IIT Guwahati is given a particular IP address. So this system's IP address is 172.16.53.127. So that you have to remember. So now to use internet, you need to have a proxy, and that proxy would be your IP address, and the port would be the number you which you give here. So the new proxy which I created, and that can be used anywhere while at IIT Guwahati, is 172.16.53.127 and the port is 1234. I'll show you. See, now I'm going to internet connection. I'm just closing it, and again I'm opening the Mozilla browser. Now see, when you open, if you give the proxy which you have been given, then you need to give the username and password, as the username and password is already saved. That is why it is asking. Otherwise, you have to give your username and password, and then click on OK. Then the internet would work, right? I'll show. Save it. Yeah, it's working now. But the thing is, this is the usual way, but now what I will do, I will change the proxy. And the proxy which I made is my IP address of the system which is in my lab, that is 172.16.53.127, and the port which I made, that is 1234. So I'm putting it and clicking on OK. Again, I am closing the browser. If I open the browser once again, now say Google, you can see the internet is working. And one more thing, now I have not been asked any username or password. So without username and password, you can use it anywhere in IIT Guwahati. Okay. So, and one more thing, suppose the many people are using your shared network, then your internet connection may become very slow. So what I suggest, you frequently change this port, say 1234, you can make it 1328, like that. So you change this port frequently in order to make your internet connection faster. So that's all, and please do it and try it and enjoy, and please comment in the below section if this video helps you, and please subscribe to my channel. I will be uploading this kind of videos. Thank you very much.